Good morning, students. Let us continue our fifth chapter, disasters, under which yesterday we had seen natural hazards and natural disaster. Disasters which occurs suddenly and which takes away the life of many people and their property. So under that we were studying about the earthquake. Earthquake, children, just a short revision of it, that it is just the shaking of the earth because of the movement which takes place just under the earth crust. And how this movement is taking place? Because of the tectonic plates. These tectonic plates, they move, and when two plates come towards each other, or they rub against each other, or they pass over each other, then we feel the earthquake. Now today we will study the measures to minimize risk. How we can minimize when an area is affected by earthquake. Earthquakes occur suddenly, and hence people should know how to handle such situations. Certain precautionary measures can be adopted, such as earthquake resistant buildings should be constructed in high risk area. So the building which is constructed could resist, means such buildings could be constructed which could resist the earthquake, which can bear the effect of the earthquake without any damage. And where it should be constructed? The earthquake prone areas, the areas which are under the high risk. People should move to open areas. It is always said, children, that when any earthquake comes, when we feel, then what we should do? We should move to an open area. Any open area. We should never stand under the inside the building or under any tree, etc. People who are indoors should have a move under heavy furniture such as beds and tables. They should keep away from things that can collapse and cause injury, such as windows, mirrors, cupboards and fans. So if by chance people cannot move out from the indoor, then they can take shelter under any bed or any table. They should not go near the windows or cupboards or fans, because these things can also collapse and can cause any injury to the people who are indoor. People who are outdoor should move away from building, trees and electric poles. They must go to any open area. Mock drills should be conducted in schools, colleges and residential complexes to spread awareness about the precautionary measures. So time to time we must get some drills in different educative institutions and in the residential areas also, so that people could be aware of these measures. Now next disaster is natural disaster is the volcanic eruption, an opening or a vent in the earth's surface through which lava gases and ash erupt is known as a volcano. Volcanoes are of three types: active, dormant and extinct volcano. So here the picture of volcano is given, and here is the mouth which is called as the opening or the vent. and through this only all the fiery materials, very hot materials, they oozes out, they comes out. And the three types of volcanoes are here: active, dormant and extinct. When magma builds up beneath the earth's crust, it forces its way to the surface through the vent. This phenomenon is called volcanic eruption. So below the earth crust lies the, very deep inside the earth crust lies the magma chamber. And when it gets any space to come out, then it comes with a great force on the earth's surface. And this process is called as volcanic eruption. The destruction in the surrounding areas of volcanoes include spreading of lava over large areas that results in burying of farmlands, forests, residential areas and transport lines. So all the things which oozes out from a volcano is very hot and in the molten state. Not everything, but most of the things, the rocks, pieces. And when they flow, they cover a large area around it. And under it comes so many places like farmland, forest, residential areas, transport line, etc., etc. Ash and steam, they erupt, cause air pollution and health hazards. So along with the fiery materials, some gases, hot gases and ashes, steam, they also escape out from this vent and they mix in the atmosphere, which causes air pollution, and again that is also health hazardous, means they put bad effect on the human health and human as well as plant and animal health. Moreover, air traffic may be disrupted and aerial animals may be lose their lives. So in this way, the volcanic eruption put the effect on the animals and the animals who live on the land or in the air. Measures to minimize risk. While volcanic eruptions cannot be prevented, we can certainly minimize the risk posed by them. In the risk-prone areas, the following measures can be adopted. First, as most volcanoes send out prior warning before erupting, the nearby area should be evacuated. So, always it is forecast or it is told or the warning is given before the eruption of the volcano, then the people who live in the volcanic prone area, they must leave the area and go to any safer place. Awareness should be spread amongst the people regarding risk prevention measures. And people should be aware about the prevention measures. People should store food and other essential items, because how long this disaster will remain on the area, nobody knows. Then the people must store food and some other essential items. Use of masks is recommended to prevent breathing in polluted air. So the use of mask becomes mandatory, so that people would not inhale the polluted air. Now floods. When rivers overflow, their banks due to heavy rainfall and submerge the nearby areas, floods occur. Floods generally occur during the rainy season. For example, in India, floods occur during the monsoon season. The Ganga Plains, Brahmaputra Basin in Assam and deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers experience frequent floods. So why it happens, this flood, when the river overflows and they break the banks and the water of the river is spread over a large area, or large area comes under the water of the this river. And why the river gets overflow? Because of the heavy rainfall. In India, this monsoon season is during this monsoon season only the rivers get flooded, and the area which are near to it, they get the worst effect of it. This year also, during this pandemic, you might have seen in Bihar and many other states, people were affected by the floods. So, all the river basins are flood-prone areas. Excessive rainfall is the main cause behind floods. Global warming has resulted in the melting of glaciers, which is also responsible for overflowing of rivers. This global warming, the temperature of the earth is rising, and due to which the glaciers are melting. And these, when the glaciers melt, the water comes to the river. Silting of the river beds and blocking of river channels by landslides also result in floods. So one cause for river flood is the excessive water. But sometimes due to silting, means the sediments, they are deposited in the bed of the river, and because of it, the river water overflows at the bank. And sometimes due to landslide, the river, its path is blocked, and it also results in the flood. Apart from rendering people homeless, floods affect agriculture to a great extent. So their property is lost here. Not only the people becomes homeless, but also it put its effect on the agricultural field. Crops are washed away by the strong water currents. Loss of livestock, and shortage of food and safe drinking water are faced by the people. Because the water which is spreaded in the area is not fit for drinking. It is unfit. So the people who are sufferer or the victim of the flood, they have to face several kind of problem, like shortage of food, shortage of safe drinking water, these all. Flood affected areas are cut off from the other areas due to the submergence of roads and railway lines. People suffer from waterborne diseases too. So, one side they get completely cut off, delinked from the other areas, because the road, railways, everything is submerged under the water. And as the people are completely surrounded by water, so they are likely to be suffered from many waterborne diseases. So now today's work, you have to find out few diseases which are waterborne. Thank you, children, and have a nice day.